Also making news this Monday night, workers at the General Post Office on East Hill Street stage yet another sit-out today to protest what they say are ongoing hazardous working conditions. Fern Carey tells us that postal workers are calling on the government to intervene.
When ZNS News arrived at the East Hill Street Post Office, workers were sitting outside the building. It's the latest in a number of protests staged by postal workers over their working conditions. While staff are still working reduced hours, president of the Bahamas Public Service Union, Kimsey Ferguson, said the heat in the building is unbearable due to a non-functioning air conditioning system.
Every other day, apparently, the generator malfunctions. The major concern is the generator doesn't have the capacity to power the air conditioning unit. Hence, the heat index in the building is increasing daily. We have summer now officially upon us, and we know how females are when it comes to the heat, and so that's a concern.
Ferguson said postal workers in the northern Bahamas are also facing similar challenges. Vice President of the BPSU Northern Region agreed.
Employees are also faced with inoperable air conditioning units, mold issues, and over the past year, we have had a reduced work day. Again, the summer is fast approaching, and it's very unbearable, very uncomfortable to be working in those environments.
Now, postal workers say these issues have been dragging on for at least 5 years now, and they're calling on the government to address them urgently.
The mail will continue to be backed up as long as this situation is not addressed as a matter of priority. The sub-offices cannot work because they're serviced through this office, and it's what it is. We have been making appeals. There is nothing new that we can say other than the fact that it needs to be given quick address.
We spoke to Permanent Secretary in the Ministry of Transport, Lorraine Ambrista, who said the government is moving aggressively to address the concerns of postal workers. She explained that the Ministry of Works is having difficulty finding parts to fix the air conditioner in the post office building as the system is old. She also indicated that the Ministry of Works is working to fix the generator, which she acknowledged is being overused. Ambrista said the government has set aside some $4 million to repair the building on Gladstone Road, where the new post office will be housed. Fern Carey, ZNS Network News.